Okay, so today I want to talk about how to get your miles in on a through hike. A lot of times, because of resupplies and just the distance you got to cover, you got to put in some long mile days. Ideally, I'd like to hike 5 to 10 miles a day, but something like the JMT, you probably got to average more like 10 to 15 miles a day because some of you might have jobs or you can't carry enough food. So 10 to 15 mile days is kind of the norm, but it's not uncommon to have to put a 20 mile day in now and then. So I'm going to give you some tips on how to get those miles in and without killing yourself. So the number one thing is to pay attention to your body and not hurt yourself, especially early on in a trip. So the number one thing to get more miles in on a trip is to hike longer, more daylight hours. And not faster. You really don't want to hike faster. You want to keep a good pace. But from experience, I know if I push myself harder than what I'm comfortable with, I'm going to end up with sore muscles. And that's going to screw me the next day and the day after that. So especially as older guys, we don't recover as fast. So you want to just kind of keep your same speed, but you want to maximize your daylight. So probably the number one way to do that is to get your butt out of bed early. I know it's hard, but you gotta get up. You gotta get up early. So that means setting your alarm. That means getting all your stuff ready before you go to bed. Have everything ready to go. Have your lunches packed and on the top of your bear can so they're ready to go. Have your breakfast ready to go. If the weather's good, ideally, just cowboy camp. Don't even set your tent up. Just sleep out on a tarp. Then you can just whip that together. And say you have condensation in the morning, stuff that stuff on the outside of your pack and let it dry off until the sun comes out later on. So the other thing I do to get out of camp early is I usually don't cook breakfast. I'm not a coffee drinker. So I know a lot of people have to have their morning coffee. I don't boil water in the morning. There are times I may, but I like to get out of camp really early. And so what I do, you could just do this while you're packing up your camp, boil some water. But what I like to do is get out of camp. You need some energy. You got to eat something. You know, you can just eat power bars all day long, but you want a little variety. I like these breakfast essentials in the morning, and I bring a little Neato along. And you just mix those in a water bottle. And shake that around, and you can just drink that right out of camp or on the trail. That gets you a start. And what I like to do is eat my breakfast after I hike a couple hours. So typically on a hike like the JMT, you're setting up near a pass. So typically you're a couple hours away from climbing a pass. So it's cold in the morning, get out of camp, start hiking, you'll be warm. That way you don't even have to worry about putting on a lot of layers because hiking keeps you warm. So get your stuff together, hit the trail, and then I'll usually bring things like granola or even dry cereal with some nuts and berries and crap like that in it. Just be creative. If you like to have hot things, one of the things that I like to do, I'll sometimes do this at a camp. I have this little insulated mug. It's a little heavy. It's not too bad. You can rehydrate things while you're on the trail. So if you are a coffee drinker, boil some water, put your oatmeal in here, and go hike a couple miles, and then it'll be ready to go in a couple hours. You can enjoy something hot. I also use this to rehydrate things for lunches, like dehydrated freeze-dried beans are awesome, refried beans, and things like meats. I'll usually put some hamburger crumbles and something you can put in a tortilla for lunch. So that thing's kind of comes in handy. So the reason you want to do that at a pass, you're fresh in the morning. You get a couple hours in, now you're on a pass. You're going to sit at a pass enjoying the view anyway. You may as well enjoy yourself and eat. That way you're not wasting time. So eat at that first pass, you're getting some rest in, and then you can continue on down the trail. So, and that brings up breaks on the trail too. A lot of people, if you're having to take a lot of frequent breaks, you're probably pushing your pace too fast. So stay at a pace that your body's comfortable with. You'll learn this over the course of a trip. So you got to feed yourself while you're hiking. What I like to do is take a little power break occasionally. If I'm out of breath, I might find a rock that I can put my pack up against and take a 1 minute break. But I like to keep my body warm, and all those quick little breaks will cut into your miles. A 2 mile an hour pace is very reasonable. 1.5 is easy. If you do 1.5 with no breaks, you know, in 3 hours you're at 4.5 miles. 10 hours at 1.5 miles an hour is 15 miles. That's very reasonable. So it's just a matter of not taking too many breaks. But breaks are really important. So take a longer break every couple hours when you really need a break. Then you just take a long break. Eat a snack and rest, and that will help you. Your body's going to tell you when you need a break, but sometimes there's that perfect spot. And I like to take breaks where I can stick my feet in some cold water or something like that too. So that helps me a lot. What you feed your body, I like to have little sugar snacks. I bring Jolly Ranchers, and you know, just things like meat sticks and stuff is fine. But one thing I really like to do, especially on the long mile days, is a product like this, or Goo. I don't even know how to pronounce this, Noon. These are just little tablets you put in your water bottles. And it gives you electrolytes and a little extra, they're supposed to be muscle control things. Some of these have caffeine in them. There's different flavors. There's a lot of different products like this. But it gives you, recharges your electrolytes. That helps a lot. And I like to drink one of those. There's some recovery type things, powders you can drink right around bedtime too, that'll help you, help your muscles recover. So rest is important. I like to take one long lunch during the day, maybe even take a nap. So take like a 45 minute lunch by a lake, maybe even swimming's great, loosens up the muscles. All those rests just recharge your body, and then you're fresh again and you can keep the pace. If you just hike all day nonstop, you're gonna get hurt yourself, you're gonna be sore, it's not gonna be fun, and your pace is gonna slow down. So breaks actually can make you hike faster. Another really good tip to get in some long mile days is to eat an early dinner. I'm talking like 5 o'clock, pull in at a nice lake or something, not to camp, you're just gonna boil some water and whip out a freeze-dried dinner, or just eat a quick meal. So you're resting while you're eating. That's probably gonna be a half hour to an hour break. Now it's 6 o'clock rolls around, you've eaten your dinner, you're well rested. You got 2 to 3 hours of sunlight based on the time of the year. Go hike while you're fresh. Go get a couple more miles in, it'll be easy on your body, and you know, after an hour or two, start looking for a camp spot. Or even consider a nice dry camp up close to the next pass. So you know, you gotta have water for that. So. Look at your maps, plan that stuff out. So that's a good one. The obvious thing is to carry less weight. And not all of us are wealthy enough to have all the high-tech gear. I can't afford a 1.5 pound tent. But try to go as light as possible. That's gonna help you a lot. You'll see these PCT hikers with these tiny little packs. They're covering 30, 40 miles a day. They're resupplying a lot, and they're uncomfortable a lot too, because they're probably leaving out a coat or a base layer, something like that. So not a good idea to go super light. You want to be comfortable. And again, it's really comfortable. You got to be comfortable at night, because probably the most important thing is your sleep and rest, because when you're doing long mile days, your body, you beat up your body every day. And if you don't get a good night's sleep, you're going to be hurting first thing in the morning. You got to get your rest. So consider, don't skimp on sleeping things. If you need a pillow, bring a blow-up pillow. If you need a full-length nice pad, bring that. I bring a smaller 3/4 inch pad. I tried to get away with a non-inflatable on my JMT, and I couldn't sleep well because I'm a side sleeper. So don't sacrifice that. Get a bag that's warm enough. I recommend a 15 to 25 degree down bag, because they're light and they're comfortable. You don't want to be shivering at night. You can get by on a 30 degree bag. Depends if you're a cold sleeper or not. But you got to get your sleep so you're good to go the next day. You'd be amazed at how much better you'll feel in the morning, and your body can recover every day. So the other thing about carrying more, less weight, you got to cover more miles because food is your number one weight. If you can cover more miles, say between MTR and Whitney Portal, that's a long stretch without food, you can skip that resupply at like Onion Valley or VVR. You got to do MTR, VVR probably, but if you can carry, if you don't have to carry as much food, if you can cut off 2 days of hiking, that's probably 4 to 5 pounds of food. So that makes a big difference. And so lighten your pack load and your body load. So obviously you got to be in shape before your hike. You can hike yourself into shape, but that's pretty miserable. Get yourself into shape. So before you hit the trail, get your butt in shape. And that means hiking with a pack on hills. Best way to get in shape is hiking. A lot of people think they're going to hit the gym and they're just going to be good. It's totally different. You're going to pay for that. Footwear is important, and take care of your feet. You want to use lighter footwear, but not so light that you're going to hurt your feet on a 15-mile day. So again, that comes with experience. And when you're in a really long day and it's hot, your feet are going to sweat, and that's when you're going to get blisters. So a breathable shoe that's as light as possible is going to be a good thing for you. I push the Moab ventilators, the non-waterproof ones. Those work well for me. So anybody can do a 20-mile day, but the problem is most people can't do it again and get up and do it again the next day. If it's the last day of your hike, it's not a problem. You can beat yourself up and you don't have to get up and hike the next day. So be aware of that. If you really need to crank out some big miles at the end of the trip, you can. Me and my daughter did 40 miles in the last 2 days of our JMT. And we were fine on the trail, but we got pretty much used all our reserves and we were hurting and could not walk the next day. So another thing that kind of is nice to do when you need to get your miles in, but when you're in these great areas of trail, is to do what I call a Nero instead of a zero day. A zero day is where you don't do any miles. A Nero day is where you do some miles. So maybe you're in the Evolution Basin or something and you're staying down lower in the valley. It's just so beautiful. You want to spend a couple days there. So get up and hike five more, just do a 5 mile day. That'll be pretty restful on your body. And then you get to spend some more time in another part of the trail. That's pretty awesome. So the last thing, if you really got to cover miles, consider some night hiking. A full moon on the JMT is actually pretty special. And you can actually hike by starlight too. It's really not a problem to hike at night if you have a good headlamp. And in fact, I've been up Whitney 3 times from the backside and I've never done it during the day. I've always got up at like 2 in the morning. In 2014, we left Crabtree at midnight and summited Whitney and we're out from there. There's a couple advantages. It's cool and you can't see the mountain in front of you, so the endless switchbacks don't bother you because you can't see them. And next thing you know, the sun's coming up, you're up at Trail Crest on the ridge and life is good. So you should try it. Just do a little night hiking just for the fun of it. It's actually pretty cool and you can get some good miles in. And that's the time you're going to see a lot of wildlife right around dusk and dawn. So those are some tips that work for me. If you have any other ideas, please include them in the comments. And again, start off slowly. You don't do the big mile days early on. You got to being acclimatized and things like that, and just getting your body used to the hiking, what they call trail legs.